We have started the lesson called as trigonometric equations. Trigonometric equations में class 10 तक जितना पढ़ा था हमने, they are called as trigonometric functions, sin theta, cos theta, tan, और इन तीनों के reciprocals, 1 upon sin cosec theta, 1 upon cos sec theta, and 1 upon tan cot theta. We have defined these things as ratios in class 10. Now we'll see how we can improve that definition of trigonometric ratios and to we'll convert them as trigonometric functions. अब ऐसा क्यों? उसके लिए हम reason भी देखेंगे. For that, let us first consider a unit circle. ये हमारा unit circle है. Unit circle मतलब एक ऐसा circle जिसका जो radius है वो one unit रहने वाला है. इसका मतलब ये जो distance है O से लेकर A तक का, that will be one unit. And in that case, ये जो point A है, इसके coordinates बन जाएंगे 1, 0. इस point को मैं B नाम देता हूँ, इसके coordinates बन जाएंगे 0, 1. ये point C है, इसके coordinates जो है, वो -1, 0 रहेगा. One unit, but on the negative x-axis. This is negative x-axis. This is positive x-axis. Then this is obviously positive y-axis and this is negative y-axis. So this is -1, 0 and this point will have a coordinate as 0, -1. This is called as a unit circle. A circle with a radius equals to 1 unit. Now why are we defining this? Let us consider. Ek angle consider karte hain, acute angle. And this is the, or isko anti-clockwise direction mein leke ja rahe hain. Anti-clockwise direction mein iska matlab ye jo angle hai, wo ban jayega hamara theta. Now, we are very much concerned about this point, What is this? It is the point of intersection of the terminal ray of angle AO, this one, suppose this is point P. So, this point P is the intersection of ray OP with the unit circle. Suppose this point P has coordinates A, P. Now, from this we understand that the distance of point P from y-axis is A and its distance from x-axis is equal to B. Okay, it means this distance will be equal to A, this distance will be equal to A and this will be equal to B. Okay, and this is the distance, obviously it is perpendicular. अब अगर ये perpendicular distance है तो इसके लिए हम sin theta और cos theta निकालेंगे. So from this direction ध्यान दीजिए, this is an acute angle. So for this angle we'll be finding out the sin theta and cos theta. So as we have said in the class 10, sin theta is equal to opposite side upon hypotenuse. Now from this triangle we have ये जो theta के opposite में है, that is this perpendicular, but this is nothing but small b. So we have this small b and hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse is OP, but this OP is radius also, but the circle is a unit circle. It means its radius is equal to 1. So we'll be able to write this b upon 1. It means that the value of sin theta is equal to b. Now similarly, we'll find out the value of cos theta also. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Now from this figure, what are we getting? Adjacent side is this one. Oh, adjacent side is this one. And how much is adjacent side? It is equal to A. It is equal to A. Okay. And then adjacent for this triangle, this is A. Okay. And hypotenuse is obviously OP. So this is A upon 1. It means the cos theta is equal to A. Now, therefore, the coordinates of point P, which were A comma B, can be written as cos theta comma sin theta. Now, we can define this cos theta and sin theta for any angle. That is why now we'll not be calling it as ratio, but we are defining it as a function. So this is the main reason that we have defined this unit circle. I hope this is clear, this much clear. In the next video, will find out what are the allied angles and what happens if this angle is obtuse angle. It means here, if the angle is more than 90 degrees, then what happens, we'll be looking at it in the next video. This is about unit circle.